in this video, we'll be showing you how to paint the Astra Militarum Cadian Castellan. We'll be using less than 10 paints to get this high-ranking officer on the tabletop ready to lead his troops into battle. If you're new to painting, you can check out the Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos. The series is linked in the description box below. The paints you'll need to follow along with this guide are listed on screen now. But remember, this is just what we recommend and what you'll need to follow along with this guide. Feel free to use your imagination and enjoy painting miniatures however you like. The first thing we need to do is undercoat the model, and for this we've chosen to use Zandri dust as this will give us a really great head start on painting the model. So the first thing we're going to do is actually use Zandri dust but straight from the pot. We'll be painting over pretty much the whole model with this colour. The reason for this is because it has a slightly different finish to the spray can, and if we make any mistakes later on, this will make tidying up much easier. Zandri dust is a base paint, so thin it down with a little bit of water on your palette before applying it to the miniature. Then we'll build it up over a couple of layers on the model. We do this to make sure we get that nice smooth finish. You really don't need to worry about being neat here, as we'll be painting the rest of the model anyway. Once that Zandri dust is dry, we're going to move on to the armour plates, and for these we're going to use Vulcan Green. Now we do want to start being quite neat here, as this will save us time in the long run, as it's less time having to tidy up any mistakes. So for this we're using a small layer brush, as it just gives us a little bit more control over the paint. This will really help with those tricky to reach areas as well. The next thing we're going to do is use Screamer Pink to pick out the cloth. Just like you did before, thin it down with a touch of water and build it up on the miniature with a couple of layers. You might find this looks a little bit vibrant at the moment, but don't worry, we'll be applying a shade over it soon and it will really tie the whole model together. And once that stage is complete, we're going to move on to painting the black areas with Abaddon Black. This is quite a thick base paint, so do make sure you thin it down with some water and apply it just as you have done before. There are quite a lot of little areas to pick out in black, and if you're ever unsure where to place certain colours, you can just refer back to the box art. But remember, these are your miniatures, and you can paint whichever areas you like in whatever colours. And with that done, we're now going to paint the skin, and for this we've chosen to use Catachan Flesh to match the box art. But please remember, you can use whatever skin tone you'd like. The face of this miniature has lots of fine detail, so it's really important to thin down that paint and apply a few layers, as we don't want to build up texture on the model and hide all that detail. Don't worry if the model's looking a little bit flat at this stage. Once we've applied a shade all over it, it will really take this paint job to the next level. Now we're going to use Rhinox Hide to pick out all the leather areas. This is a great choice for painting leather, as once we've washed it with Agrax Earthshade, it really looks worn and aged. Again, some of these details are quite intricate, so just take your time and be as neat as you can. The less tidying up we have to do, the better the end result. But don't worry, you can always go back in with previous colours and just go back over any mistakes. The next thing we're going to do is move on to the gold areas. For these, we're going to be using Retributor Armour and sticking with that small layer brush to help us be really neat. This is a metallic base paint, so do thin it down just as you've done before and apply a few layers of it. This is a really nice, rich gold, and again, once we've washed it with Agrax Earthshade, it will really bring the model to life. Once the gold's done, we're going to move on to the silver, and for these areas, we're going to use Iron Hand Steel. This will be areas like the buttons and some details on the weapon, and don't forget those buckles too. This is a really nice and bright silver, and even once it's been washed, that brightness will really come through. Once you've finished using metallic paints, it's always a good idea to change your paint water. This will just stop any of those metallic flakes getting into your non-metallic paints and making them shiny. And once that's finished, we've actually got all of our base coats on the model, so we're ready to move on to the final couple of stages. Now it's time to shade the model, and for this we're going to be using Agrax Earthshade. We're actually going to be using this in two different ways, the first of which is to thin it down with a little bit of water. What this will do is give us a more subtle effect on the model, which is great for going over those really light areas. We'll be using this over the Zandru Dust, Vulcan Green and Screamer Pink areas, as applying it straight from the pot would just be too strong and might result in an inconsistent finish. Then we're going to take it straight from the pot for the metallics, leather and skin. If you ever find a shade pooling too much in the recesses, just clean off your brush and use that to soak up any excess. The final stage of this guide is to apply an edge highlight of a shabty bone. We'll be using this to highlight all those Zandru dust areas. Again, stick with that small layer brush for maximum control of the paint. You'll need to slightly thin down the paint just as you've done before and make sure that you've got a really good point on your brush. And where you can, use the edge of your brush along the hard edges of the miniature. This will give you a really quick and easy highlight. This will be quite a bold highlight, and this is because it's the only area on the miniature we're highlighting and we really want it to stand out and draw the eye. And there we are, your Cadian Castellan is finished and looking awesome. You can see that our model is based, and if you'd like to learn more about basing, you can check out our video all about it. Well, we hope you've enjoyed the video and we'll see you next time. Bye!